going to start. This obviously is Karen. And Karen's going to give you a start with a little background about her and her life, and then she'll walk into the degree. So, Karen?
Now, welcome. I grew up in Eastern Europe as a little child, surrounded from my parents. Like, they were artists too. Like, my father was a sculptor and a painter, and my mother did jewelry. And so, and I grew up in this close to Berlin, in this Potsdam, this historical city. And so, I was in this intellectual artist bubble in East Germany in my whole childhood. And I thought this is normal.
You're doing really nice skills.
And it was really nice because the art was in Germany. You know all this critical stuff later, but as I was a child in the 80s, it was also like the freedom for my parents. They had such a freedom in their art because they didn't have to care about it. They could just do their art, and so that's how I grew up. Just to care about the other things you have survived. You could survive anyway, and so I... And yeah, this was how it started. As I was 4 years, I loved to paint and to sew. I started at around 7, because my mother was doing this all the stuff, like making little art pieces on her own. So my parents also had exhibits, so it was really just an art community. And then later, right before the war came down, the bubble popped. So it was like this political stuff was going on also with my parents. They fought against the government, and my mother was dying. And we had to leave the country. And so, and then I realized, oh wow, the world is much harder than I thought. And I think I stayed with my art because I really needed it. It's my emotion.
And you also said that your father was jailed.
Yeah, my father was in jail. He had to go to jail and was tortured. So
the West Berlin, they paid for you to come over.
Exactly. And then the relatives and the government and all this political stuff, they paid us to. They paid the government in East Germany so that my father could get out of jail. And my sister and me, we didn't have to stay with other children. And like for children, it's how the kids would lose the parents. So. And so then, in West Germany, totally opposite, I went to the uncle, to the relatives too. And I was like, it's like a movie for me because I had to stay in South Germany. My father ran away with a new wife. And he sent me and my sister to his father's brother, and he was an art collector. So I had to stay in really fancy houses, all servants, but also with his art again. Like, and of course, he was a real art collector all over Europe, and he met some artists too. So I still had this art around me, and this was my hope too. Always this life what brings up for me. So, I stayed with my book. But it felt after a half year, it felt really like a golden age too, because I lost the freedom from before in history. It was all equity, whatever. My parents were really liberal, but it was like just totally strict. I had to learn how to behave, like this, how to eat, and all this. My love is all. the art. And all, but also with collaborations, like, because for doing a living, I studied costume and stage design too. And that's what I'm going to do, like designing for theater and opera. Because I grew up with all these thinking intellectual people around me, so I needed the input or the influence from all the other thinking people and cultures. So, yeah. And yes, what should I say?
I think you can start talking about.
Yeah.
And you came to California also.
Oh, and then, yeah, of course, yes. I came to California. I used to live here too as a student. Like, I went to the University of Berlin as an art student. And then also, I got a scholarship to go to Pell Arts here in Valencia. And so, this was 26 years ago. 26 years ago, I think. So, for 3 years, I lived here. And this is how somehow my connection to Los Angeles, California. My daughter actually studied last year here in UCLA, so I came back and then I found the gallery.
Okay.
So, and my technical, so this is the main, my main painting, because this is right after I did this, prepared it for the show, everything, and this is like, it's like the clouds. I don't have to explain my paintings. For me, it would be worse if I have to explain everything. I can explain the technical stuff, but I think my work should be about emotions, and if you feel it, then I'm totally happy. If it, because everything what touches me, like in my heart, I have to express, and I just have to do it. So, and so this, yeah, but this is like the hope, like the color for the way, the highway. So, and this is very important, because last year I was here and California inspired me as much as almost every piece I did after in 1 year, because I was so inspired from the colors and the light here. So that's just flow. I had no hard time. So almost every piece. This is from a period before, but this is also like the columns and the lacquer, and but also like the historical buildings in the Potsdam, where I took this historical stuff in Berlin. Yeah, but this was the first piece I did, as I didn't know I will have a show here, so that's why I have it here. And this is for me typical how I felt after leaving here. That's just my hopeful, happy piece.
Yeah.
And this is all a series. It's like this way from here, like the tunnel. Oh, I shouldn't, haven't talked about the technical stuff, how I found this. Because as I was 7, I learned how to stitch. And my mother also did like stitching on paper, but with fabrics. And as I was 10 or something, I thought maybe it's interesting to use the thread as instead of a pencil. So that's why my lines are always with thread. And also I like the move, the jellyfish on the other side. As we walk around, I like this three-dimensional stuff, and also that it has this motion, so that not the line, so the. Because I also like stories, little stories, but more moments, like make you, I don't know how to explain. I like, sometimes I think that every piece is a story for me. Like maybe emotional story, but also sometimes just really, I don't know, it should be alive. So that's why I like when the thread is moving, so you have different views, and so like in life, different perspectives to change, because here I look at things totally different than in Berlin, and so this is, that's why I think it's nice to have this thread, not really, okay. And then, this is the columns from the Lagma, and also from what I said, and this is all the series here. This is also the architecture I'm interested in, what I'm doing. Set design also. And so, center at Twin Peaks. I got so inspired from the light up there, the sunset and the sunrise, that I was somehow overwhelmed. And so I tried to find this crazy light back in the gray winter time in Germany, because right before I came here, it was really gray winter time. So, and so I made my word to this house. So, and this is how, it's not actually exactly like it is over there, but this is how I see it over there. So, somehow like a fairy tale, like really magic. So I hope you get it. And I really love this. I didn't know this is poppy season, but I did this flowers already, like waiting for spring. And then this piece is actually one of my favorites, because it's also this nature, but this is like if this would something grows in between people, like friendship, and though the trees are like people or something, or like things, and this little tree is like something is growing in between, so it's like the light is coming through and it's growing. So, and these are all the highway series, because I have a different bodies of motion. This is just really go together with the main piece in the beginning. And this is actually, this was like a sketch for the big piece over there. Because now I'm starting to do much bigger pieces. I started really small on paper, like little postcards, really, really thin, because stitching takes a lot of time, and it's really like, sometimes, of course, I have to stitch by hand, so, and so to do a big piece, it's even more, it's intense, so.
Beautiful.
Yeah, it's gorgeous. Yeah. And this here, these are actually the oldest ones. This I did a long time, like 10 years ago. And this was one of the first ones, because this was after the World Trade Center. Because I just visited this right before, and then it happened, I just had to do this. This is really when I'm it comes to me like really, oh wow, if I'm super happy or if I'm sad about something, I just have to do it, or if I'm interested. And because this year is when I travel a lot, and this is just a few out in Kuala Lumpur, was the room where I stayed, and then this is a few out of the door here. So this is the same period, you can tell the colors and so on. It's changing always. So
can I ask you?
Yeah.
Your smaller works.
Yes.
Mostly give you sense of late evening, late afternoon evening,
yes.
Storm,
yes,
coming.
Yes.
I would guess it's done in California, inspired by California. But your large paintings,
yes,
have a daylight.
Yes.
So there's a difference.
Yes.
Is that incidental difference, or it means something? On a large scale, it's daytime. On a small scale,
Maybe. Yeah, I hope this the daytime is. I don't know. I would say it's a time thing. It's because I did. This is really maybe in this moment I felt didn't feel as much joy as in this paintings. Maybe. Don't reflect too much about my work. It's more like I'm surprised what other people see, and so I'm happy if it means something. I don't think
someone means something.
Yeah, of course. This is
very, very deep.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I would say that our weather has caught up with you for these.
Yeah, I know. I was here as this weather was like this. But it's so dramatic here in Europe. It's more like I said to my friend, here it's, the colors are much brighter and the contrasts are much brighter. And this is totally interesting for me.
Yeah.
But some pieces, they are really delicate, like this one I did in Europe, because we have more this gray and more this not as much contrast as you. It's how the life is here, I think, too. It's much more joy, but also much very stressful, too. And for us in Europe, I have the feeling it's more, it's also stress, and so, but it's not as as hard, or as contrast. No, hard, I wouldn't say, I don't say that something's better or just mean more intense, this is like me, I couldn't decide if I would live in Germany or here, because I love it here totally.
Half and half.
Yes. So, and then here. This is a jellyfish. And here is really this thing when the wind is coming or if you, depends. I always say when somebody buys this to his room, that would be nice next to a window or in Germany to a heating, because I really love when it's like waving practice. So.
Beautiful.
And my daughter is studying marine biology, and she loves oceans.
Wow.
And this is,
Oh, sorry. It's okay.
I mean, somehow, I was very serious with this piece, like thinking about historical, like Turner or all this landscaping, European serious artists. And somehow, I'm a funny person too. As you can hear, here's music, and I had this concept with my friend. He's a composer. We work sometimes together in theater, opera house. So we are really close friends, and I said, I get a show in Los Angeles, maybe, do you like to compose something for my paintings? Because we have to compromise when we work with this, all with other people, but for here you have the freedom. And I said, oh yes, I would love to compose something for you. And so that's the music you can listen to. I think this should be the room where you just don't talk and just dive into the paintings with the emotion. That's why I think the writing for my paintings is not words, it's more music. And so, and he was inspired mostly of the big ones. These are the really last ones right before the show. Because this is a step further than the other ones over there. It's more like my dream. And this is also from the beach. You can see. Oh, and this one here is one of the first ones I did. Here it's really like the thread is like the pencil. It's mostly like a sketch. And so, and on this side, this one, I used the thread different, because if you walk through from different sides, you can see the different colors, and it's this three-dimensional. Very delicate. So the thread is all over here. And here, this is the older one too. Like, look up and what's. Yeah.
Again, here are most of the paintings inspired by the daytime.
Yes. Yeah, maybe. Yeah.
With exception.
Yeah. 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 Maybe. Yeah.
I just saw that.
So is your friend writing music inspired by you, or you listen to his music, and inspired by his music, you're doing something in your paintings?
We had a collaboration, really. We did this together, like for 5 or 6 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
I sent him the sketches and also the steps from my paintings, and he gave me some music, and then it was really a collaboration, really like this. And because I know him since 12 years, mm-hmm. I did know somehow what to expect. And I also love this shadow, the springs, mm-hmm. because the title Floating Springs also is a
yeah.
Yes. So, yeah, if you have questions, ask me.
I was assuming you do the string while it's on the canvas is on the framed up, or I'm sorry, if, I don't know if that's where I was
asking.
Yeah.
If you come closer, you can see that I did the string all over. This is like 10 different colors, if you really look close. And so you can see it from here and here.
So you're stitching, obviously, on top of what you've already painted.
Yeah, but it's different. Sometimes I stitch and paint, and so I wouldn't say I leave it open. As I think sometimes I paint, stitch, and it's not really, I have no.
There's no rhyme or reason.
Even the edging, now he has stretched everything, but sometimes it's like open ends too, like a wire to raw edge. Yes.
Yeah.
That's so cool. All of it is amazing.
No, nice.
Thank you. Do you plan on continuing in this style, or do you plan on changing or evolving it? Do you have any idea of what is in the future?
Yes, yes. I have many ideas to just come. I have a show in Germany soon in August, and I have also a solo show. And yes, I'm planning to have larger pieces. I think it's much more impressive, much more. I this is like sketches somehow maybe, or it's like you can see the development, and now I really can trust, I have more,
confidence.
It's more intense, no, I have confidence, this is not a problem, this is not what I meant, it's like, I like to maybe to focus longer and deeper in something, in the topic of. And also I would love to do more that the thread is like when this piece is more in the dimension comes out maybe. Yeah. And this movement with the jellyfish, this is also somehow new, the jellyfish. So before the show I didn't have the jellyfish, some the first pieces. And I think this direction is interesting to have this more with movement.
Questions?
I don't have a question, but I just have a comment. I think they're beautiful. And I especially like the light, just the subtle and very bright light in some of your dark paintings. I think that's beautiful. And I have a question. Is that light the canvas showing through, or is it ink or paint as well?
It's both. It depends on how it looks. Oh, I think how intense the light should be.
So is a lot of that you create, the light and the dark, is that improvisational? Does it surprise you when it shows up? Or are you more deliberate when you're making those marks on the canvas?
I'm not really good at deliberate or conscious.
Deliberate? Like conscious of doing it, you decide to do it?
Do you
or
plan intentionally?
Or accidental?
It's both.
Okay.
It's not that I'm totally in it and then I don't reflect. Maybe I said it wrong before, but I look at it too. Yeah, but I'm always, it's also like an adventure for me.
What?
It's like an adventure. Like, I'm totally happy when something is, like the light is, wow, then it's like so much fun for me.
It looks really spontaneous.
Yeah, it is too.
Yeah.
But it is maybe spontaneous, but I draw since I'm 7.
Yeah.
So every day almost. So
right.
It's really, I let it go. I don't have to. Then I don't use photographs or something. It's just,
that's beautiful.
I wonder what you would do with Joshua Tree's yuccas and cacti.
Yeah, I'd love to try to see. The light is probably different again. Striking from the Yeah, nice for coming. Thank you.